Hello, hello, and welcome to the last game. I'm gonna comment from Tata Steel Chess Tournament in Wegen Zee 2020. And today it's not only about the game, it's more about the final standing. So let's see the game. As white, Alireza Firouzja, 2723. And he is young prodigy from Iran. So very talented young gentleman who just is on the first big tournament and playing with the best in the world in the classical time format. So big hope for the chess. And now he faces Daniil Dubov, one of the most creative players, grandmaster from Russia, and his ranking is 2683. So without further ado, let's go to this game. I'm trying to make it as much exciting as possible. So we have d4 by Alireza Firouzja, d5 by Dubov, knight f3 and knight f6. And now exciting bishop on f4, so London system on the board, ladies and gentlemen. And now c5, the most active move, not the most popular, but really active, attacking the center. Very exciting stuff so far. We have e3, so a very careful approach by Alireza Firouzja, and here we have knight on c6. So these knights are very actively covering the center. Really exciting stuff so far. Knight b2 d2 by Alireza Firouzja and knight h5 attacking this active bishop. This bishop is the most important in London system, and ladies and gentlemen, it's gonna fall. So black gonna capture this. Now the question is where this gonna happen. So d takes on c5. Alireza Firouzja pretends he doesn't see that, and knight takes on f4. Of course, e takes on f4, and here we have g6. If e6 is played, for example, then white will try to create the possibility of pushing f5, which gonna be really exciting stuff. But g6 by Dubov, so he want to, you know, develop the bishop on g7 on the very, very strong diagonal. So c3 preventing that, bishop on g7 anyway, and now bishop on b5. So Alireza Firouzja didn't go for knight b3. Everybody was expecting knight b3. That's so strong move, because now after the castle, bishop on b5 could be played now, and that's the big difference. After queen on c7 and castle by white, queen would take on f4, and after queen takes on d5 and rook going to d8 attacking the queen, queen could go to c4, forcing to exchange the queens, and now white would have so active gameplay. Ladies and gentlemen, that would be so incredible. A lot of threats, a lot of threats. And also these pawns, four pawns on the queen side are incredibly strong. So really missed opportunity by Alireza Firouzja. I'm not really sure what he was thinking, but bishop on b5 was a little bit too early. So we have now castle by Dubov, and here another inaccuracy. This knight on b3 was still possible. It was still possible to play that, but Firouzja go for safety first. So he just castle. And here we have incredible move by Dubov, d4, so active move. Here we have bishop on c6, and now look at this, d takes on c3. This is incredible stuff. That's the top level chess. Now we have bishop on e4, and look at this, c takes on d2, creating this passpawn, very dangerous passpawn. And and here actually it was so dangerous that Firouzja take it by queen, and there is nothing to do here, so just exchanging the queens on d2. And here Dubov has great move, bishop on b2. So winning the pawn, and now the structure of the white pawns are really not great, because there are two pawns, both of them are isolated. And these pawns not really great against the classical structure of Dubov, and Dubov still has bishop pair, so this is very exciting stuff now. But actually I think we should just switch the sides and show how Dubov gonna play this game. So rook a on b1 was played, we have bishop on a3, so moving from the harm way, and now c6. This is so exciting stuff. And in this position, believe me or not, but both players agree for a draw. So yeah, move 16 and we have draw. And most of the games finish that way in this round. So this is why really a great approach by Caruana that he didn't go for this. And of course, that would be not fair if I say that all the games went so short and not exciting fashion, but I try to make it a little bit spicy. And yeah, for example, Magnus Carlsen with Wesley So, Magnus Carlsen said that he tried to win, but the position was very symmetrical, very boring, so I'm not really sure. I know Anish Giri try to win. He had extra two pawns in the four rooks ending, but he didn't manage to win. Actually, Jordan Van Forest play really great defense, so that would be, you know, not fair to say like all the players play this way, like this game happened, but yeah, that's how the most of the games just end up. So we had seven games, six of the games were drawn, and only Caruana won with Artemiev. Okay, let's jump into the final standings. Okay, here we go. So Fabiano Caruana, the winner, 10 out of 13. Incredible score, 7 wins and 6 draws. And this score is actually the record of the tournament, and we have the 82nd edition, and only Magnus Carlsen in 2013, Garry Kasparov in 1999, and also Alexander Bielawski and Viktor Korchnoi in 1984 ex-aequo got so outstanding score, like 10 out of 13. So he just joined, and you know, the winners, not only, you know, by winning, but doing it in style until the end. So 7 wins out of 13. Magnus Carlsen, former world champion, 8 points out of 13. So 2 points behind Fabiano Caruana. That's a huge gap. And 3 wins, very solid tournament, but drawing so many games definitely doesn't help to win. And then we have Wesley So, also drawing most of the games, but he managed to win 2 of the games and got the 3rd place. And then we have Jordan Van Forest, the big surprise for this tournament. He came to that tournament extremely well prepared. In the openings, I cover a lot of his games. I cover a lot of his games. So if you want to see more, just go to my playlist. And I think that's really interesting stuff there. And also one of the most creative grandmaster, Daniil Dubov. He also got 7 points, so also 4th place. And then we have Anish Giri, Vishwanathan Anand, Jan Krzysztof Duda and Alireza Firouzja getting half of the points. So 6.5 out of 13 in quite different style. Because, for example, Giri won 1 game and lost 1 game, the same like Duda, but Anand played more aggressively and lost 2 games, but managed to win 2 games. And Alireza Firouzja played even more aggressive. He lost 4 games, but also he won 4 games. So That's the style of usually that's the style of 16 years old young players. If players are older, they are, you know, more tend to draw. And then we have Jeffrey Xiong and Vladislav Artemiev, 6 points out of 13. And actually, Jeffrey Xiong lost to Vladislav Kovalyev. If he managed to win with the Vladislav Kovalyev, then he could get 7 points. And this tournament could be quite good for him, but he didn't. Nikita Vityugov, only 5 points out of 13, but he was a replacement for Jan Nepomniachtchi and probably didn't prepare for this tournament. He just lost 3 games and drew the rest of the games. Yu Yangyi, a Chinese player, he also should play much, much better, lower than the expectation. He's very strong, grandmaster from China. 2700 he has for a couple of years, so he was expected to play much better, but he only lost 4 games and drew the rest. And Vladislav Kovalyev, who won the Challengers Tata Steel in 2019, that was his first big tournament to play against so strong opponents, so he just need to learn. That was a new experience for him, but definitely also could try to do better. Probably he did the best he could against so strong top players of the world. Okay, so that's being said, that's the final standings of Tata Steel Chess Tournament in Vegas Z 2020. So at the end, I would just want to tell you that like this video, press this like if you like what I'm saying, and if you don't like, press unlike and leave the comment. What do you think about this all drone games in the last round, and what do you think about Fabiano Caruana, who definitely I'm very impressed of his behavior, how he act until the end, how he tried to win for the 6 hours games. When everybody just enjoyed the tournament was finished. So that was pretty interesting. And I'm gonna cover more games of Akiba Rubinstein as I started his saga, one of the strongest players, especially in the rook endings in the chess history. So, you know, feel free to subscribe to not miss any of these games I'm gonna cover, especially if you want to, you know, improve your rook endings or pawn endings. But life of Akiba Rubinstein is very dramatic, and it's also with a lot of episodes, anecdotes, so I think it's a good show as well. So consider to subscribe. And yeah, thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.